It's Chris Budgets here, and thanks for visiting my channel. If you watched my last video, then you know that I was under budget with my first paycheck of the year. I just received my second paycheck, and we're just gonna start fresh. I'm actually doing two challenges this year, and one of them is the Zero Out Challenge, and the other is the 1 in 5's Change Challenge. So with that being said, I did get paid today, and I transferred any remaining amount other than my cushion to my savings account. I'm gonna start fresh with this week's paycheck. My paycheck was $683. That's the leftover amount that goes directly to my personal checking after my automated bills, mortgage, joint expenses, auto savings, deductions, insurance, and everything like that. My husband and I do split the bills, and we also have separate accounts also. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and put this stuff to the side. My Verizon bill is the only thing in this week's paycheck that I have to pay. So that's the only bill for this pay period. I'm going to go ahead and grab my Budget by Paycheck Planner. This is the printable version from the Budget Mom. And what I have here is, here we go. I'm actually not supposed to get paid until Friday, but my financial institution that I bank with pays me on Wednesday, so of course a few days early. I typically get paid around $500. I did do some overtime this week, so that brought me to $683. From that $683, Verizon was a flat $200, so that brings me to $483. I have groceries, food, and gas, so that's around $170. $190 including the gas. I'm actually going to leave that amount, the gas amount, in my checking account. So when I do pump gas, I'm just going to leave it in my checking account so I can just swipe my card so I don't have to go up there and do cash and everything like that. It's just more convenient, and you know, that part is the only part that has been working for me. I am going to go ahead and switch back to my cash envelopes for like my grocery and household items, and then food and miscellaneous. That kind of goes hand in hand for us. So like eating out on the weekends, we normally eat out on the weekends or on Fridays. And then my husband and I, we might stop by like a Starbucks or something like that. So that is what we categorize under our food. Groceries and household, you know, just like it says, anything we need, food, milk, eggs, your basics, and of course like toilet paper, laundry detergent, and things like that. I didn't write down my sinking funds, but because I do have my sinking funds in here, but I know my sinking funds, I will take out $200 pretty much every paycheck, if I'm able to, pretty much. So that's a flat amount as well. So that actually brings me to around $93 for my leftover. And I'm going to go ahead and put that towards, it's going to be an extra debt payment, for my Wayfair credit card. So that brings me to a, zero base budget right here. So that is my overview there. So let's go ahead and fill up these savings envelopes. Let's see here. Here we go. So I do have these little trackers. I got these for free from the Budget Mom. And if she has a lot of free resources online, I've said it in my past video, and I do say it on Instagram all the time. I do follow the Budget Mom. I don't follow absolutely everything that she does, but she really has a lot of free resources out there, especially if you're like a visual person or you need to just, you know, be more organized like me. That's what I lack. I just need to be more organized. I just need to be more consistent, and really track my spending on a daily basis, or at least at every other day basis. But she had these, and I printed these out, four on each page on my printer. And I did have them in here, but I didn't want to have to keep taking them out and putting them in. So I thought it was more convenient that I just kind of kept them onto the side. So I have the amount here. For example, this is for my car insurance, $400, car, $675, That's like car maintenance, oil changes, which my husband usually does. But this is really for things like tires and like those kind of parts that go bad. And then you have to go buy parts type of stuff. So, you know, some stuff like that. House maintenance fund for when our AC breaks in the summer and the heater breaks in the winter. You know how that goes. My daughter, my husband, I have one for me, miscellaneous, and so on. I just need to get better with like coloring it in. I need to just steal some markers or colored pencils for my daughter's little desk. So let's see here. So the first one that we have is my insurance. And actually, I don't have like a cash drawer or anything, you guys. I'm just like a regular. I've been seeing those like super cute cash drawers and everything on everyone's YouTube page and things like that. And they're so cute. I recently saw like a DIY one, like a bedazzled one, it's just so cute. But I'm just a regular deck. I'm gonna have put my daughter's banana on the side and get all of these ready. So we are gonna do our sinking funds first. So first is insurance. Insurance gets 20. Car gets 25. House gets 20. Most of these do get 20. Aria gets 25, and this is for my daughter. This is actually in addition to the automatic savings transfer I have into her bank account, and on top of the other automatic transfer to her Utma account. 25 for her, $20 for Eddie. I don't know what we're saving money for Eddie for, but we're gonna save him some coins. $20 for me. Miscellaneous, $20. Christmas, for this Christmas sinking fund, this is really just for like the food. Christmas Eve is normally at our house every year, and we have all of our family, but due to the pandemic and everything like that, we just had, you know, our parents and, you know, our siblings over. So for Christmas, this is really for all the food that I have to buy and make and for Christmas gifts. So Christmas, holidays. Notice holidays is only getting 10. These are like for those potluck holidays, you know, like July 4th and, you know, Easter and stuff like that. So that's that kind of holiday. And then birthdays gets 20. And that is it. That's $200 to my savings envelope. This is actually like my personal like miscellaneous fund. I have some cash in here. If I leave the house, I'll normally take this if I'm just leaving the house to leave the house. If I go to the grocery store or anything like that, I will take my grocery store cash with me. And this is for my 1 in 5s challenge. Let's see how much I have in here. Have a 10 in there that I threw in there. Just trying to be ambitious, you guys. And then the rest are 1. So 10, 20, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, and 32. Okay, that's really good, actually. 20 days into the year and $32. Wait, was that $32? Oh my gosh, I can't count. Hold on. 10, 20, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. Okay, yeah, $32. You see? And this is why I got to get it together because I can't count. So that's $32. So that is our savings sinking funds. Now, for the rest of these, I do have my cash envelopes that I'm switching to. So let me grab those. I have my miscellaneous and my groceries. So if you saw my last video, you know I was $200 under budget, and I'm not really even sure where that came from, what the numbers, how I crunched the numbers, I don't know. So I basically, I'm starting over this paycheck, so I'm gonna go ahead and switch to these cash envelopes. If you saw my Instagram, you know that I made these, and I got these for free. On the Budget Mom Resource Library. She has a ton of free stuff. If you sign up for her newsletter, she sends out a freebie pretty much every Friday. It's like envelopes and trackers and meal planner charts, lots and lots of free resources from the Budget Mom. So groceries and miscellaneous, and this miscellaneous is actually, I probably should have put food, like our going out to eat food, but that's okay. Groceries is actually gonna get $120 and miscellaneous is gonna get $50. So let's do this groceries first. What did I say? $120. Let me just check my chart over here. I don't want to fill it in with the wrong amount. Okay, so $120, $20, $30, $40, $50, $60, $70, $80, $90, $100. And I don't like these bills facing all different ways. 100, 10, 20. And that's gonna go for our groceries. And then for our miscellaneous, look how cute these little cacti. So cute. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, perfect. So this should last us 2 weeks. And one thing I want to challenge myself and my family, I want to challenge us to use what we have in our kitchen, what we have in our pantry, what we have in our freezer. I have a lot of meat in our freezer, so I'm trying to use that up. I'm trying to make sure that we finish our leftover foods. We either eat them again for dinner or for lunch, or we pack them for work. So that is something that I'm trying to challenge us with, and I'm just trying to cut out the frill. So no more oatmeal cream pies for me right now. I don't need to spend those $2-3 on a box of oatmeal cream pies. I don't need it. I don't need the calories, and I don't need to spend those few dollars. So that is my challenge for this paycheck. I always try to challenge myself to do something different, even if it's just for those 2 weeks. Why not? It won't hurt. You know, if I can't do it, I mean, I have the money to shop. And we also have a cushion fund. You know, we have so many resources, that we can pull from, you know, if we need to. But I just want to challenge myself. So I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Hopefully we'll see what my first paycheck of February brings. And hopefully I am not over budget, and hopefully I'm not too much under budget either. So thanks for watching my video.